Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghu here. In this class, we discuss about decorators in Python. In our previous class, we clearly discussed about how functions are passed as variables to the other functions and how we return the function variables. So there are, in our last class, we discussed about the examples, how they work, how the memory is allocated. All these things are clearly discussed in our last class. Based on the assumption you are following our previous class, we will continue this class. This class completely dependent on the previous class. Please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete Python language. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's example, before going into the concept of decorator, let's try to understand one example that is related to decorators so that it is easy to understand the concept of decorators. The example here is, this is the example which we are considering. So what's this example? In this example, we have written two functions. One function is def f of. F is a function which is taking two parameters, x and y. And what's the functionality of this function? It is adding these two variables, x plus y, and placing it in a variable called z, and we are displaying that variable. That is the functionality of the function f. Means it is doing addition of two numbers. So what happens if we want to do some, if we want to apply some condition on this function without changing the functionality of this function? Try to understand, it's bit complex to understand. So we want to impose some condition on this function, on this logic, without changing the functionality of this function. That is what we have to do. Can we do it? Yes, we can do it in Python. How to do that? Let's try to understand how we are trying to do that. We are trying to impose a condition on this function without changing the functionality of this function. So in order to do that, we are using a new function. The new function is myDecorator is a function. It is taking an input variable. In this myDecorator function, we are having an inner function called, named it as inner. In this myDecorator, we are having inner function, and this myDecorator function is returning the reference of this inner function. This concept, in our previous class, we discussed, we are returning the reference of this inner function. So that is what it is doing. MyDecorator is a function which is taking an input variable and returning the reference of this inner function. Means it creates the inner object. The object of this function, that reference is sent back. That is what this function is doing, myDecorator function is doing. Now come, let's understand how we do that. So let's, f is equal to myDecorator of. What's this line of code is showing us? MyDecorator function, we are calling the function myDecorator. For that function, we are sending the reference of the function f. This is what the syntax of myDecorator of f. MyDecorator is a function, we are calling that function. For that function, we can send a variable. Which variable we are sending? We are sending the reference of the function f object. What happens here? It will create a function object named f, and that reference is sent to myDecorator. So what's this? MyDecorator is taking the reference of the function f, and it is returning the reference of the inner function. That is what it is doing. So myDecorator is sending reference of f, and this myDecorator will send back the reference of the inner function. So now f is pointing to the reference of inner function. This inner function. Now if you call f of 6, 6, which function will be called? Inner function will be called. This function will be called because f is referring to this inner function. That is what happening. So what we have written in this inner function? And one more important point we have to understand, inner function is inner function of this myDecorator. Means this inner function has access to use this func variable. So what's func variable is having? MyDecorator of f means it is placing, the reference of f is placed in func. If you use func, it is calling the function f. That is what happening here. Try to understand it again, watch it again and again, but this concept is very, very important to understand. Okay, so FENC is having the reference of F. If you use FENC as a function, which function will be called? F function will be called. Okay, in the inner function, what's the logic we have written? If x plus y greater than 10, then call the function FUNC of x comma y. FUNC of x comma y means which function will be called? This function will be called. It will add and display the output. Else, print x plus y less than 10. Don't call the function. Means we have imposed a condition. What's the condition we imposed here? If x and y values, if you addition of these x and y values are greater than 10, then do the addition. Otherwise, don't do the addition. That is the condition we imposed on the function f without changing the functionality of this function. We can do this in this function also. We can write the statement if x plus y greater than 10, then z is equal to x plus y. Otherwise, else print x plus y is less than 10. We can do it here also, but why we are doing it here in a separate function? You try to understand. Suppose this is the important concept. So this is what the definition of decorator. Let's try to understand the definition of decorator, then we will understand what's the use of this. Why we are writing the functionality in other function, imposing the condition using other functions. So the definition of decorator is, decorator is a function which imposes condition on other function without changing the functionality of other function. So the same thing we have done here. Decorator is a function, my decorator is a function which imposes condition on other function. What's the other function here? F is the other function, without changing the functionality of this other function. That is what the definition of a decorator. So what's the use of it? Suppose if I want to apply a condition on this function, I will write a decorator. If you want to apply a different condition on this function, you can write your own decorators. So in this type of situations, we use decorators. Okay, now let's take the coding part, how we can use this, how the definition of the decorator will be written. So the same function we have, this is the code, my decorator, whatever the example which we explained, this, that is the code, f of 6 comma 6, it is displaying it as 12. Okay, instead of here we have defined this my decorator of f, this is using the variable f. Instead of this, we can write it as the same function, but syntax, we are using the syntax of decorator here. See here, this is the line which there is no need to use this line. Instead of this, if you write it as @my_decorator, this function name, this works exactly same as our previous example. These we call it as decorators. This function is decorated with this function, decorator function. What's this decorator function will do? It will try to impose some conditions on this function without changing the functionality of this function. That is the use of decorators. This is how we define decorators. The same output we will get, f of 6 comma 6 means 12. Now understand more complex of chaining of decorators. Chaining of decorators means, see here, we are defining a number, function called num, and this function is returning the value 10. On this function we are applying two different decorators, two different conditions. So decorator is a one decorator, the second decorator is decorator 1. On this function we are trying to impose two decorators. In our previous examples we applied only one condition. Here we are applying two conditions. That is what chaining of decorators. How we use this, it is very important. Decorator 1 of decorator of num. What's happening here? Decorator of num, what it will do? Decorator of num means the reference of this num function is sent as input to this decorator. Okay, the FUNC variable of decorator function is pointing to number function, and this decorator function is returning the inner function the same way. What's the code here? We will try to understand later. So this function is returning inner. what's the inner means? Reference of this inner function. Reference of this inner function is given as input to decorator 1. So understand it, it's bit difficult. The reference of this inner function is given as input to decorator 1. So the FUNC variable of decorator 1 is referring to this inner function. And this decorator 1 is returning the inner function, reference of this inner function. That is what happening here. So how it will get executed? Whenever we call the function, now that reference, the returned reference. So finally, decorator 1 is returning the reference of this inner one. This reference is given as to the variable called num. Whenever you call the num function, it will call the function of inner one of. So how it will get executed? So whenever we call the function num of, decorator of num means number is called. See, FUNC of decorator is given as num. So in the inner function, what is happening? X is equal to function of. Function of means which function is called? Number function is called. What this function will return? It will return 10 value. So x is equal to 10, it is returning 2 into 10 means 20 is returned. That is given as input to the next one, inner one, decorator 1 of. So decorator 1 of is calling the function inner 1 of. X is equal to FUNC of. Here FUNC is calling inner of. From this, what's the value we got? 20. So 20 into 20. 400, that is the final output, that is 100. So that is the output which we got. How to write it in decorators? Instead of writing this line, we have to mention it as @. How we write it? The same function which we discussed above, we are writing two decorators, decor and decorator 1, decorator and decorator 1. It is applying from bottom to top. That is how it will pass the chaining of the functions. So this is the syntax for chaining of decorators. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.